Level 815. Well, on the same day that Philadelphia announced its first case of Zika, New Jersey announced its second travel-related case of the virus. The health department says a woman who recently returned from travel to the Caribbean is the first to be infected by Zika in our city, a 6-year-old woman. Now, officials said that she is now recovering without complications, and the Zika virus is most commonly transmitted from the bite of mosquito, but we've also known recently that it can be transmitted through sex. So what does this mean? The spring break, just a few weeks away, we are bringing in our travel expert, Jennifer Donches, to go over the latest travel recommendations. Now, Jennifer, I have to admit, a lot of people, they're worried about this Zika virus. When they hear that now it's in Philly, and as a woman to travel to the Caribbean, does that mean people shouldn't go to the Caribbean?
I think it's really presumptuous to say the Caribbean. The CDC has a list of the countries in the Caribbean that have the mosquitoes that can transmit that virus. But not every country in the Caribbean has that. The Bahamas. No cases of it. So you really should first look to see what islands. And we put up a map right now. If we were to put up the map of the United States, the entire United States would have it because there's at least a case now in the United States. So even if you look at Mexico, for example, with a lot of spring break, people are traveling to Mexico. But the state of Quintana Roo, which is where Cancun and the Riviera Maya are located, hasn't had a single case. So we've had more cases in the United States, 101.
Yeah.
Right now? So you really have to watch what you're going to spend your money on for cancel fees if you're suddenly scared of this virus.
Because those fees can, this of course is the U.S. map. These are all the states where we have, you know, of course, Philly and Pennsylvania and New Jersey are on there. But what have you noticed anyone canceling their plans? A lot of people thinking, oh my gosh, spring break's coming up. Are they canceling?
Well, I think a lot of women who are pregnant or are trying to get pregnant, just like if you were going to go get an x-ray. And I think that's what Dr. Ars mentioned in the last segment. It's not clearly known if in the next 5 to 10 years this is going to come back. But what they do say is that it's out of your bloodstream in 14 days. So if you're pregnant and you're going to one of the countries that the virus is definitely transmitted there, the CDC lists them, you can get a doctor's note and the airlines will give you your money back. Doesn't mean the hotels are going to do it, but the airlines will. But you have to be pregnant. So if you're not pregnant, and you don't have a doctor's note, you're going to pay a lot in change fees or lose your money altogether.
Because you decided not to, which is a personal decision, but you would be losing a lot of money. Now, for the doctor's note, though, is it a form? Or I literally just go to my doctor, hey, doctor, I'm pregnant, I need you to sign something, and then I'm going to call the airline and let them know, hey, I have a note.
Right. Hey, I have a note. If you say I'm going to the Caribbean, they're going to look at the list from the CDC and see if it's that destination. If it's the Bahamas, there are no cases there.
Yeah.
You're not going to get your money back. So what do you do if you are going? You're still worried about it. You don't want to cancel, and you want to make sure that your kids don't get sick and your family doesn't get sick. So what you need to do is you need to actually prevent this by using bug spray. By every time you get out of the water, putting on the bug spray. There's a lot of resorts out there right now that are really going at this full force, like Sandals and Beaches, for example. They are spraying every night. They're giving away free bug spray to everybody. They're leaving pamphlets in the room saying how to avoid this. And guess what? It's not in St. Lucia. It's not in Turks and Caicos. It's not in the destinations where a lot of the sandals are even located, but they're doing this to avoid the scare. So,
and also, I hope they're doing it. If they're not offering these refunds for women that are pregnant, I hope they are spraying them.
Absolutely. Spraying, getting rid of stagnant water. I mean, they have foggers, and they've been doing that, and same in the Riviera Maya and Cancun as well. So, just because the mosquitoes are in that country doesn't mean the virus is there. Zika's been around for a long time. These are the same mosquitoes that carry dengue fever and West Nile, and we don't hear about that, right? So if you were pregnant, I would definitely avoid going to Brazil because that's where they have the most cases right now. And I just talked to a travel expert and get advice and get tips on what to do and how to prevent it.
Okay, and we're so glad that we have you, our travel expert, Jennifer, to explain this to us. So keep us updated then on how that goes as we get closer to spring break time. We appreciate it. Thank you so much. Our 819, Mike.
Can women and men just be friends? It's an age-old question. Well.